They may have the skills and the burning passion, but for young Africans dreaming of playing in England's Premiership or turning out for, say, Inter Milan or Barcelona, raw talent and desire are not enough.
It's a footballer. It's a footballer, but it's England, not a footballer.
But how do young hopefuls like Francis play for England? This new documentary reveals they have no choice but to enter the murky world of corrupt agents in countries like Ghana, where greasing palms is not optional. It's the way they do business.
If I've got a player and then I want a coach to fill them, I have to pay. And even I don't mind even footing all those bills. It's not a problem at all.
Football Fables is the work of Bafa Koto, an up-and-coming director who's been telling Bloomberg the success of players like Didier Drogba fuels the ambitions of young Africans, but few actually make it.
These guys are very much the inspiration for more players, even more young boys to look at that as an aspiration, as the path to follow. They're very much role models. The more success there is, the more people are going to chase that dream, however unlikely it is to come about.
In the film, Francis did make it to England, but is still not on the books of any club, a fate which befalls many young Africans who get into Europe.
If you want to call it irregularities or corruption, you can do, but I think that's to simplify the matter. What you have is people who operate in a certain sphere, which isn't necessarily regulated as such, but they are feeding into a regulated system.
And when we watch the African stars in the weeks ahead, this film is a reminder of how some had to work their way through a corrupt system to make it onto the world stage. John Cookson, Bloomberg News.